In the last video, we studied the syntax tree, the DAG representation. And in this video, we're going to study another intermediate representation, that is three address code. So three address code is a type of intermediate code which is easy to generate and can be easily converted to machine code. So as I said in the previous video, the syntax tree or a DAG is a high level representation of intermediate code, and it is very closer to source language. So we have another representation, that is three address code, that is low level intermediate code representation and very closer to machine code. So today we are going to study what is three address code. So this three address code uses at most three addresses and one operator to represent an expression, and the value computed at each instruction is stored in temporary variable generated by the compiler. Okay, what is three address code? In three address code, there is at most one operator on the right hand side of an instruction, only one operator. So let us consider the source language instruction, example x plus y into z. How to convert this expression into three address code? First, okay, what we are doing using this arithmetic, initially we are computing y into z, isn't it? Therefore, let us take one temporary variable t1 is equal to y into z. After that, we are performing addition. Already we computed y into z, where the result actually in t1. Therefore, t2 is equal to x plus t1. So this is called as three address code for the expression x plus y into z. So what is t1 and t2? They are temporary names generated by the compiler. See, what is DAG? What is syntax tree? DAG is a variant of syntax tree. So what is tree actually? As we studied, it is a non-linear data structure, right? Tree is always considered as non-linear data structure. Now we have to generate a linear representation of this non-linear representation. So what is that linear representation? That is called as three address code. See, let us consider the same example. What is this expression? A plus A into B minus C into, sorry, what is the expression? A plus A into B minus C plus B minus C into D. So this is what the expression, and we generated DAG for this particular arithmetic expression. Now let us derive the three code address. Okay, so what is three code address? Initially we want to compute b minus c, that is stored in temporary variable t1. After that, a into t1, so that is stored in t2. Next, we are performing addition with a. Okay, so where is the result actually? T2, right? A plus t2, that will be stored in temporary variable t3. Okay, one expression is over, and the next is again t4 is equal to t1, already we computed, right? T1 into d. And finally, what is t5? The t3 plus t4, right? So this is called as three address code. Now let us study some of the basic concepts of three address code. Okay, how to generate three address code? Look at this concept. Three address code is built from two concepts, addresses and instructions. An address can be one of the following: a name. For convenience, we allow some source program name to appear as addresses in three address code. For example, I, A, B, J, etc. So all these are variable, I mean identifier in source programming language. So we can use that. A constant. In practice, a compiler must deal with many different types of constants and variables. For example, 10, 20, 8, 3.141, etc. A compiler generated temporary, because in order to compute the result, the compiler uses some temporary variable like t1, t2, t3, etc. So these temporary variables can be combined if possible, and while generating the machine code, this compiler uses registers, okay, for these allocated variables. I mean, it is useful especially in optimizing compilers to create a distinct names each time a temporary is needed. These temporary can be combined if possible when registers are allocated to variables. In the previous video, we studied a list of addresses for three address code. Now let us study three address instruction form. See, the first one, that is x is equal to y opz. What is op? Op is nothing but it may be arithmetic, binary arithmetic or logical operator. Binary arithmetics are plus minus into division, and logical operators are like and, or, not, etc. Look at the second one, x is equal to opy, where op is a unary operator. For example, minus x, minus y, etc. X is equal to y, it is a copy instruction. Go to L, an unconditional go to. Look at this example, arithmetic expression, a into minus b plus c. So let us convert this is into three address code. So first we'll going to compute b plus c, right? Okay, t1 is equal to b plus c. Then the minus of this particular expression, that is t2 is equal to minus t1. Then what is t3? t3 is equal to a into t2. It's very simple, right? Conditional jump. If x go to L, if false x go to L, if x relop y go to L, means conditional jump. X, if x means x is equal to true, if false x means not true. So it has to go based on some condition, it has to, control has to skip for some position. Similarly for the third one, x relational operator, x lesser than or equal to y, if this condition is true, it has to go to L. So like that. Procedure calls using, here we are using some special names. If there are some parameters, okay, the parameters are represented by param, p-a-r-a-m, param x. Functions are called, that is call p, n. What is p here? P is a function name. And n represent number of parameters. Okay, if the function uses three parameters, then p comma 3. Okay, what is p? P is the name of the function. Y is equal to call p comma n, means the return. Okay, the return type is assigned to y. The return address is assigned to y. We'll see, okay, all this with the help of some example. So this is indexed copy instruction. X is equal to yi. And xi is equal to y. Maybe this type of instruction, source instruction is maybe available, right? Similarly, address and pointer assignment, that is x is equal to and y, x is equal to star y, star y is equal to y, all pointer assignment. First one, x is equal to and y, address is assigned to x, x is equal to star y means content of y is copied to x. Star x is equal to y means y is copied to x. So let us take one example. See here, C code. What it do? Only instruction I is equal to I plus 1 till a of I lesser than v. So it is repetitive instruction. Just go on executing I is equal to I plus 1 until a of I lesser than v. How to generate three address code for this particular example? Initially, t1 is equal to I plus 1, initial computation I plus 1, right? Let us store in T1. That is assigned to I. Now I is equal to T1. First you compute I is equal to I plus 1 means I plus 1 that is assigned to T1. I is equal to I plus 1, therefore I is equal to T1. Now after that we need to compute A of I. See A means, what is A of I? A means the starting address. Let us assume the starting address is somewhere 2000. Okay. So A of I represents 2000. What is the next memory location? A of I plus 1. What is the address? Let us assume it is 2008 byte addressable. Okay. 2000. What is the next address? 2008. Look at this same example. A of 0 and this is A of 1. And what is the width? Byte means 8. Okay. Therefore, we need to compute. Look at this. T2 is equal to I into 8 means byte. Then T3 is equal to A of T2. So we'll get the actual location now. If T3 is lesser than V, then go to L. So now it is repetitive. T3, what is T3? T3 is nothing but A of I. How to compute A of I? Initially you compute I into 8, actual memory, okay, memory length. Then T3 is equal to A of T2. If T3 is lesser than V, then go to L. So this is symbolic labels. If you want to use position numbers, we just use, okay, 100 or maybe 1000 or maybe 2000. It depends on you. So it stores in, first instruction will be in 100, second will be 101, like that. Okay, instead of go to L, you just directly go to 100. More convenient. Okay. Let us generate three address code for the following code. What is the code? For I is equal to 1, I less than 10, I plus plus. What we have to do? Till condition is true, we have to execute A of I is equal to X into 5. What is the initial step? Initially, assignment. Initial assignment. What is that? I is equal to 1. Let us write as it is. Okay. And what is the next step? Okay, we have to compute A of I is equal to X into 5. Okay, T1 is equal to X into 5. Fine. Now, this result has to be copied to A of I. Now, initially, I is equal to I into 8. T2 is equal to I into 8. T3 is equal to A of T2. Right. Now, T3 is assigned with T1 because X into 5. A I is equal to X into 5. After that, okay, the instruction is computed. Next, what we have to do? We have to increment I is equal to I plus 1, right? Okay, I plus 1. T4 is equal to I plus 1 and I is assigned with the T4. After that, we need to check the condition. If I less than 10, go to L. Simple. Okay. Now the implementation of three address code. There are three representation of three address code, namely quadruple, triples, indirect triples. Okay, what is that? Quadruples, triples, indirect triples. Let us study the first one. So what is quadruple? It is a structure which consists of four fields, namely operator, argument 1, argument 2, result. Okay, so how many fields? Exactly 4 fields, that is operator, argument 1, argument 2 and the result. Operator denotes the operator, argument 1 and argument denotes the two operand, and result is used to store the result of expression. What is the advantage? Easy to rearrange code for global optimization. One can quickly access value of temporary variables using symbol table. Disadvantage, contain lot of temporary variables. Temporary variable creation increases time and space complexity. Okay, let us study with the help of it. Consider another example. Let us write three code as well as the quadruple. Okay, so A is equal to B into minus C plus B into minus C. So first write three address code. Initially we'll compute, because unary operator has highest precedence, right? Okay, so first compute t1 is equal to minus c. After that b into minus c. Okay, when we evaluate the expression from left to right, so what is the next computation? B into minus c. Minus c is already stored in t1, therefore t2 is equal to b into t1. What is the next step? Again t3 is equal to minus c, t4 is equal to b into t3. Then what is the next result? We have to perform the addition. The first result is in t2, the next will be in t4, therefore t5 is equal to t2 plus t4. Finally assign the result to expression to the operand a. A is equal to t5. It's very easy to write a quadtuple. So what is the number of arguments in quadtuple? 4. One is operator, argument 1, argument 2, and the result. Okay, so this is the header. Now look at the first one, first row. What is the operator? Minus. And number of argument is only 1, right? That is C. Argument 1 contains C. And the result, where the result will be stored? In T1. Look at the second three code address. It is into, operator is into, argument 1 is B, argument 2 is T1, and result will be T2. Third instruction, T3 is equal to minus C. So minus is the operator, one argument, that is C, and result will be stored in T3. The next one, that is T4, is equal to B into T3. Operator is star, argument 1 is B, argument 2 is T3, result is T4. The next is plus, argument 1 is T2, argument 2 is T4, result will be stored in T5. The last is A is equal to T5, operator is equal to, argument 1 is T5, result is A. Simple, right? The next representation is triples. This representation doesn't make use of extra temporary variable to represent a single operation. Instead, when a reference to another triple's value is needed, a pointer to that triple is used. So it consists of only three fields, namely operator, argument 1, and argument 2. Okay, so this is the previous example and the three code, three address code. So now let us create the triples. How many column here? Only three column, that is operator, argument 1, and argument 2. And we won't use result. See, same example is converted now. What is the first one? Minus C. Operator is minus, argument 1 is C. That is assigned to address 0. Clear? And what is the next instruction? T2 is equal to B into T1. Okay, so operator is star, argument 1 is B, and we don't have T1, right? We don't have to use temporary variable, hence it is 0. The position is 0. Understood? And result will be stored in the 1, position 1. And the third one is minus C, result will be in second, 2. Next, T4 is equal to B into T3. So operator is star, argument 1 is B. What is T3? It is 2, right? Next plus, what is T2? T2 is 1, it will be stored in 1. And what is T4? T4 will be stored, that result will be stored in 3. Okay. Now what is the last statement? That is equal to, operator is equal to, argument is where to assign to A, is equal to A, okay, that is 4, in position 4. Consider the indirect triples. So what is indirect triples? This representation makes use of pointer to the listing of all references to computation which is made separately and stored. It's similar in utility as compared to quadruple representation, but requires less space. Temporaries are implicit and easier to rearrange code. Okay, so the same example here. So we have triples, right? The triples. So the number is 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. In indirect, okay, in indirect triples, it will store only the address. Okay, so in 0, it will store 14. What is 14? That is in the triples. Okay, so very easy. I mean, saves the memory. Okay, that is the use of indirect triples. Now let us see some of the problem. Okay, so the program is given, and what we have to do, we have to write the three address code, okay, for this particular example. Look at the first example. Okay, so what is the example? Look at the example one. N is equal to f of a I. Okay, the given statement is n is equal to f of a I. So what is this actually? This belongs to procedure, right? F is a name of the function, and how many argument within that function? Only one argument, and the value will be returned to n. Initially, I want to compute the address, right? Address of a i. So t1 is equal to I into 8. I mean the size of I. What exactly the size of I? It is, let us assume it is 8. So it is I into 8. And t2 is equal to a of t1. It depends on the size of I. Fine. Next, param. What is the code here? Param. Param is used to represent the parameter. So what is the parameter here? A of I. Where it is stored? In the temporary variable t2. Therefore, param t2. And after that, we have to call, right? What we have to do? We have to call the function. Call f, 1. Call is a keyword. We are calling a function. What is the name of the function? F. How many argument? One argument. And return value is stored in temporary variable t3. And finally, it is assigned to n. N is equal to t3. This is first example. Now, let us consider one more example. Sum of a, b, c. How many parameters? Three parameters. What is the name of function? Sum. Okay, so whether we have any array variables? No. So directly you declare param a, param b, and param c. So there are three parameters, you just declare it, and after that you have to call, right? You call sum. Call sum, comma, how many variables? Three. So call sum, comma, three. That will be stored in some temporary variable called t1. Let us write quad tuple for the example 2. How to write a quad tuple? So this is three code, right? Okay. So quad tuple, four fields. The first one, param a. Param is a operator. A is argument 1. Param b, param c. Okay, the last one, call. Call is a operator. What is the argument 1? Sum. What is argument 2? 3. Where it is stored? In t1. Okay, so this is quad tuple for procedure. Now let us consider one more expression, that is a of I is equal to b into c minus b into d. Okay, let us write three code first. T1 is equal to b into c. T2 is equal to b into d. T3 is equal to T1 minus T2. Now the result will be stored in A of I. So let us compute the length of I, that is I into 8, that is T4, and T5 is equal to A of T4. Then in T5, where is the result actually? In T3, right? So T5 is equal to T3. How to write the quad tuple? See here, four field. Initially, first operator is star, argument 1 is B, argument 2 is C, result will be stored in T1. Similarly, second instruction, star, B, D, result will be T2. And the third one is minus T1, T2, T3. And fourth one is star I8 result will be stored in T4. And look at the array variable. Okay, now it is operator array. Argument is A. Another argument is T4. The result will be stored in T5. And finally, operator is equal to T3 and result will be stored in T5. And this is the assignment. For the first question, what we have to do, you have to write quadruple, triples and indirect triples for the expression x plus y into y plus z plus x plus y plus z. And for the second one, you have to write syntax tree, quadruple, triples and indirect triples for the expression a is equal to b of I plus c of j. And the second one, x is equal to star p plus and y. See here, the star and are the operator. Remember, it is a pointer, right? Address operator. Okay, so solve this. Thank you.